I'm so gonna get run over. Okay, hold on. We gotta find a good spot because I have questions for you. Holy crap, where's good?
And we have answers.
You do?
All of them.
Okay, Blog Buddies, it's official. I have them here. Hi, Kit and Vixen.
Hi.
Let me tell you, when I heard that you guys were on the cruise, I was like, freak out because I'm a fan. Are we visible, Blog Buddies? Is it too dark? Are we good? We're good. We have a professional videographer helping us out. What's your name again?
Brennan Callen.
Brennan, can you turn around and do a big hello?
Yay! Hello!
Hi!
Thank you. I'd like to thank all the people helping me
to
get here.
Nothing but the best for my. Now people call you the Goths. Now is this okay? That's what I hear people tell you. But I mean I didn't know if that's cool because I never called you that.
It's fine. Yeah. I mean there's way worse things you can be called on this episode.
Totally. Yeah. And I think it's a compliment because look how fantastic you guys look.
Thank you.
Like commit to it, and that's what I love. When I saw you on The Amazing Race, because you're the first season I ever watched.
Oh, wow.
And I said, that's my team right there. Right.
Hopefully you didn't put any money on that.
I know I didn't. But how long ago did they shoot The Amazing Race?
It took the entire month of July and the first week of August to film.
Wait, this most recent summer?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay, and how many countries did you go to?
We went to 8 of the 10 countries.
Yeah.
Holy crap.
Yeah, places like Croatia, India, Africa, Ireland, Amsterdam. I mean, just beautiful places.
And you're from where originally?
We're from Louisville, Kentucky.
Believe it or not.
Louisville, Kentucky. And you still live there?
Yes. It's still home sweet home.
I went to the Derby, you know. Have you ever been to the Derby?
You know what? I have never been.
You have never, but you have been
to the Derby ever.
Oh, I went and I wore a hat and I committed.
You wore the hat.
Yeah.
Are you going this year?
No, when's was
enough?
I did win $57, but it's not about me. It's about you. No, you're not both this tall. Can we zoom down and show the shoes?
I'm not tall, but I'm good at faking it.
Yeah.
Well, whenever I see people who I love and who are willing to, I love to bring them to the Blog Buddies and sort of ask the questions that the Blog Buddies would like want to ask you.
We're here to bare our souls.
Yeah. Okay, so when did you get the look? This is what I need to know. When did you commit to it? Because I'm a fan.
Well, during my teenage years, I was a fan of horror movies and fashion, and all those things kind of came together for me in the goth scene.
Yeah.
You know, for us, every day is a fashion show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's true. But, I mean, we've always sort of felt, at least for me, like a little bit, just a little bit like the odd man out. Like, I never quite really fit in. And I tried so hard.
Yeah.
I tried so hard for years, and it just was, for whatever reason, it was not working. And finally, I decided, you know, I can either spend the rest of my life being sad and you know, whining about the fact that I'm not belonging to everyone else.
Yeah.
Or I can celebrate the fact that, for whatever reason, this is who I am and have fun with it and enjoy it. So we kind of describe the goth scene as kind of like the island of misfit toys. It's like the kids who don't quite make sense, but when you put them all together, it's a pretty colorful family.
So in Louisville, you meet each other at what age?
Oh, we met each other about 3 years ago.
Okay.
I was passing out flyers for Goth Night, incidentally.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I passed her one, and she was like, oh, I like the flyer, but I like the boy a little bit better, so.
I have a bit of a thing for a boy in makeup.
You do?
Yeah.
Quick, someone give me a compact. Because, listen, I'm telling
you.
Yeah, gonna. Do you have an extra?
Sure.
Extra or six or seven.
That is funny. Now, how is it that you came to be on the Rosie Cruise? How did this, or the Our Family Cruise?
Well, we found out Rosie O'Donnell is a huge fan of The Amazing Race.
Oh, totally.
She watches it every single season. She's with every episode.
Yeah.
And the people that run the cruise got in touch with us and invited us aboard. They said, Rosie really loves the cruise. She loves the Pink and Black Attack. Will you all come aboard?
The Pink and Black Attack.
Attack.
We were so
I'm making friends on the boat.
Yeah.
Hi.
But we were so flattered to be asked to this. We were just honored to be a part of a cruise that's really so special. I mean, it's so positive. Everyone's so happy. I mean, we loved every moment of it.
This is our very first cruise, our first trip to Mexico, very first cruise. And it could not be a better experience.
You're going to love it. Cut to you in 10 minutes playing shuffleboard. I swear to you, you're going to love it.
Everyone is so warm and so friendly, and the vibe here is so just loving and sweet, and like we've already made like tons of new friends, and it's a blast. I mean, I love it.
Our family vacations. Check it out.
Oh my God, you're doing a commercial now. Yeah, I love it. Hi.
Hey, sweetie. Hey, sweetie.
Do you know these people? You're making friends.
Yeah,
it's so easy to make friends because everyone is just warm and friendly and fun and perfect.
Have you were late getting on the boat, which I find hysterically funny because you're from the Amazing Race. Like your job was to get B places on time.
Sadly, our flight to get to San Diego to get on the ship was delayed. Uh-huh. So it was impossible to get here in time. But in true Amazing Race fashion, we rerouted our travel from Cincinnati to Orlando to Houston to Cabo San Lucas, where we intercepted the ship at its first port. So
was there a little time thing down here while you were doing it?
It felt like it. Especially toward the end when we found out our luggage went to Puerto Rico.
What? Sorry.
That's a bad day. Puerto Rico instead of San Jose, Mexico. Because they both have sand in them, so you can't blame them for getting mixed up.
Right. How much baggage did you have?
Oh, God.
On the Amazing Race, how much baggage did you have? Because you have to carry that all with you, right?
Oh, God. Our little bags, they were, like, bursting.
We basically purchased the largest possible, like, bag you can have that's still considered a carry-on. Uh-huh. Like, it's kind of pushing it, actually, a little bit.
I want to know this. Two things about the Amazing Race. One, do you get to do your laundry? Where?
In the bathtub, if you're lucky, if there is one.
Oh, could never do it.
With, like, shampoo, like hotel shampoo.
Yeah. What about number two? When you're in, like, the dun-dun, that when the music's playing and you have dun-dun 4 minutes and it's a rush, dun-dun, and you really got to use the, you know, piddle potty. Do they do a timeout? Can you be like, hey, timeout, y'all, I got a
tea break. Yeah, no.
Sadly, there's never...
There's no timeouts on the Amazing Race, unfortunately. I mean, there were definitely times we could have used them, but you just have to kind of.
I don't know if I could do it. I really like to think that I could. I don't know who I would do it with. Who is someone you know? Because you guys got along very well. Who could you not have done the Amazing Race with?
Ooh, it would have been challenging with my dad.
Yeah.
Or my sister. Uh-huh. Or my mother. Or any friend I can. He's pretty much it.
You just listed everybody else in the world.
Yeah, he's pretty much it. I mean, Kent is a perfect partner for me. Like, I couldn't honestly. Like, I love all those people with all my heart, but I can't imagine having the Amazing Race.
Listen, it's a different story from. I love my mother. I mean, just adore the woman. Yeah. But I would freaking go bonkers in a minivan with her and a plane traveling the world. We would just be like, mother.
See, I love my mother, but I wouldn't want her to have to go through all the stuff we went through. Like, I'd feel terrible for her. I don't want my mother carrying heavy stuff and being dirty and hungry, and it would break my heart. Well, I just couldn't handle it. I don't think so.
The thing about the Amazing Race is, you know how you feel when you're late for work? And you're, like, driving as fast as you can, your heart's racing, you're sweating, you're jittery. That's how we feel 24 hours a day.
Just
like, it never stops.
That panic mode, like, constantly.
But on one hand, it was the most stressful experience of my entire life, but also the most fun and fulfilling that I've ever enjoyed. So I wouldn't trade it for $1 million.
Yeah. Well, do you think that if they ever have, and listen, I'm just no pressure here, but if they ever have an Amazing Race, where they get to, like, bring a third person along, that you would ever have me be, like, the third
one. Oh, you are at the top of the list.
Are you for Sierra?
I will christen you with this backpack.
Yes. No, let me carry it. Yeah. Hurry up! I gotta go!
Let's go!
We just ran into Blog Buddies.
Hi! What's
your name?
I'm Amy.
Amy.
Okay. My mom, Linda.
Oh my goodness. Hi,
my
Brittany.
My partner, Marla.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Ken and Vixen.
Say hi.
Ken.
And I'm Vixen.
Good to meet you guys.
Oh my God, they're amazing.
Yay,
on the Amazing Race.
Where are each of you all from?
Bay Area.
Bay Area. Yeah.
Did you vote for the first annual Ross Blog Talkie Award?
Absolutely.
First annual.
Absolutely did.
Do you remember the words of the song?
I don't.
First annual Ross Blog Talkie Awards, not the second Ross Blog Talkie Awards. You voted Ross Blog Talkie Awards. We'll blow your mind at the.
Da, 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 da.
I write a good song, you guys.
You do. But I saw when you blogged from Rosie's room on the ship this summer, and your mom was in the room, and it was great.
And Sharon Glass and Jeannie, her best friend.
You were so happy because you were like in Rosie's room.
That's right.
You were pinching yourself.
Always.
Great.
Well, I love meeting a blog buddy.
Thank you.
High five.
Great.
Thank you so much. Great. Look for them on the blog.
You're sorry, I didn't know the details, but I love your blog.
You're on the blog right now.
Okay, hi bloggers.
Bye, you guys. Bye.